With a game as large as Warzone, there's bound to be a few problems, especially when updates come out. This week in particular has been pretty big in terms of new stuff coming into the game, like new red door locations to allow you to teleport from one side of the map to the other or to random locations. But this has also come with its own problems, like creating invisibility glitches that players are running into while trying to use the red door transportation system. There's also been some more bans taking place on the side of Raven. They tweeted out the other day that there have been over 50,000 accounts banned from Verdansk. Unfortunately, I feel like this ban streak might just be a band-aid on top of a much larger issue. As many people have said online, even though your account gets banned, there's always the opportunity to go out and create another one and of course cause havoc once again inside the game. This week, it seems like there's been an uptick to the amount of people using God mode with these cheating services. I've seen plenty of clips on Reddit and Twitter, even some Twitch streamers running into them live. Combine everything we just talked about with the invisibility that random players are getting, not even trying to, by the way, just by using the red door transportation system, and this creates a pretty toxic environment online. It makes it hard to play this particular game. There is some good news, though, in the pipeline. A new report came out earlier by Video Games Chronicle that mentioned that there were over 100 new people added to the Warzone team. That means, in less than a year, the team at Raven has grown by over 50%. And with more people being hired on a daily basis, this is good news. In fact, there's been some pretty notable people added to the Raven roster over the past couple of months, including Ted Timmons as the brand new creative director for Warzone. He actually used to work as Far Cry 6's game director. We also have Manuel Torres Pineda, who used to be a lead animator at Respawn. He is now the lead AI animator at Raven. And last but most certainly not least, we have William Fine, and he used to be a senior producer on Fortnite. But that doesn't stop there. I mean, there's tons and tons of other developers that have been hired from so many different companies, Respawn, Ubisoft, and even some shifting around in Activision from certain studios being placed on the Raven team. So there's a lot happening with Warzone, and they see that it is a huge investment, and they see that it is a very popular thing. So obviously they need to jump on that. But will this change what we see with the cheating situation? Are a portion of these new employees going to be placed on the anti-cheat slash enforcement team internally in Raven? We don't really know, and that's not going to be something that's pretty much shown overnight, unless there's a huge update and they basically put it out there for everyone to know. But as of right now, with these latest bans, there have been over 500,000 players banned from this game. Out of those 500,000, how many did the workaround to make a new account and start cheating again? We'll never truly know. But that is a staggering amount of people. Unfortunately, because of all the cheating that's happening, I think that Activision is really having a hard time keeping up with the amount of people that are cheating, because there are so many people playing Warzone. You know, I find it kind of funny because people always say Call of Duty's dead, there's nobody playing it, but there are millions upon millions upon millions of people playing it. 500,000 is a drop in the bucket compared to the amount of people that have played Warzone. I think it's over 100 million at this point. It's insane to me that even with a game that's so large bringing in so much revenue, it doesn't seem like there's been a solid resolution to everything that's been going on since Warzone dropped. And unfortunately, it's getting a pretty bad reputation right now. Even though it's one of the biggest games in the world as we speak, it still has a very bad reputation for cheating. Unfortunately, because of this, there has been a subgenre of content being created around professional Twitch streamers, pro players, content creators, and whether or not they're actually cheating. And I'm talking about super deep dives into the content that they've created on YouTube, the Twitch streams that they do live, detailed dissections of every single move and whether or not the reticle looked a little weird or it snapped on a little bit too fast. And although some of these videos have caught streamers actually cheating with programs, it seems like a large majority of these videos that are coming out about content creators and streamers are nothing more than just pointing fingers and then making them have to defend themselves about cheating, when in reality they're not cheating, they're just that good at the game. And I said it before, and I'll say it again, I think I said it like 8, maybe 9 months ago at this point, but it's been a long time. If there's anything to be done with cheating, Activision basically has to step in and stop it. I will give them credit, however, because they did make a very transparent post back in May talking about all of the different core values that the team has and what they're doing to try to stop the rise in the amount of cheaters in Warzone. However, that credit kind of goes away because they haven't really made any type of effort to try to be communicative at all in regard to what they're doing now. Instead, we've kind of seen posts that just say, hey, a ban wave went through and we banned 50,000 people. Hey, a ban wave went through and now we're up to 500,000 people. That's pretty much all we're seeing. We don't have any actual deep dives into what has been done other than what they told us back in May, which is still good because they were transparent to an extent, but for many players out there, it's just not good enough. They wish they were able to hear more, and I get it. My whole result of this and all of the stuff that's happening is I'm just not going to play it. And I haven't been. I just... Warzone is fun when there's mysteries and there's Easter eggs to solve, but I cannot tell you guys how burnt out of Battle Royale I am. I'm just sick of Battle Royale games. When this new payload mode comes out, I am totally jumping in because it's something completely different. It's out of the ordinary. It's not something that we've seen in Verdansk so far, and I'm ready to play that mode. I know a lot of you guys probably feel the same way. I know many of my viewers have mentioned how they just dislike Warzone because they're burnt out on Battle Royale. I feel the same way. That's why I'm so excited for a new mode. But I do like exploring the map. I like all the little mysteries and the Easter eggs that happen. But I get it. I totally sympathize with the people that have fallen in love with Warzone, that want to see it succeed even more than it already is, that want it to be a clean place to play. I totally get that. But it all comes down to Activision, like we said before. They got to do something about it. We know that Activision is capable of taking action pretty quickly on things that are bad or will harm the game experience. We recently saw in the past week that there was a new cheating service that was going to be opening up, this time very easily accessible, even on console, and they struck it down and basically went for the head right away, and it is no longer being produced. The creator of the program basically put out a big letter saying that he's no longer making it, it's not going to be released, there's no more production on it. Activision sent him a cease and desist, and that was the end of it. So they can strike. It's just a matter of how they're going to do it, I suppose. I'm just happy that that was taken care of quickly, but I know that this issue is much, much bigger than that single cheating provider that we just talked about. There's so many different ones out there, so many different ones that have kind of flown under the radar, and there's still so many players out there that still cheat to this very day. I realize it's probably impossible to get rid of every single cheater because there's always going to be someone that tries to exploit the game. But if we could get rid of, and I don't know, maybe I'm being generous when I say this, 95%, maybe even 90% of the cheaters in this game, it would be much better for it. I mean, I don't think there's anyone denying that. It would just be much better for it. There's so many different times where people get into lobbies. There's so many video clips that come up online. There's just so many people live in stream being caught off guard with God mode and crazy things they shouldn't see in the game. And it just feels like, even though there's ban waves happening, that doesn't really seem like it's a fix. It just seems like a band-aid on a broken bone or something. Let me know your thoughts about this down below in the comments section. If you guys enjoyed this conversation here today, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.